If there's one thing we've learned during this pandemic, it's how to properly wash our hands. Let's review. Step 1, rinse hands. Step 2, apply soap and scrub-a-dub-dub for at least 20 seconds. Step 3, time to dry. Just go grab a... Maybe use that one? Dang it, why is this so hard? We know that sounds dramatic, but drying your hands properly is really important.
I mean, every time we touch a surface, we are potentially transferring bacteria, pathogens, if we have any on us. If you have a wet hand, you can see the mark you leave.
It goes the other way too. Germs hop more easily from surfaces to your hands if they're wet. But public health messaging often fails to address this last step. And in the COVID era, people are confused. A recent study found that the pandemic scrambled the hand-drying preferences of Americans, and that many want clarity. So let's clarify. Do electric dryers do more harm than good? Is there even a best method? And which bathroom appliance is the real public health fill-in? Generally, in public bathrooms, you'll find three hand-drying options. We asked Dr. Christian Morrow to break them down.
The first one is the warm air dryers. They dry through evaporation. So they simply heat the water up, help it evaporate, removes off the hands. The second one is the jet dryers, which are the more modern ones that we see. And the jet dryers work with sheer force. They just simply force air under the hands and it just shears away the water molecules. The third option then is the paper towels. And paper towels, same again, one other option. We don't always do it properly where we get into the cracks and properly clean our hands. You know, if we dry them properly and put them in the bin, that's a way to get, you know, pathogens, moisture off our hands and into a secure department, into a bin. A trash can, as you call it.
Paper towels and hot air dryers have been duking it out for bathroom supremacy since the early 1900s. Paper towels mostly won, except for a post-World War II paper shortage and in the 1970s when McDonald's installed dryers at all of its locations. Savvy businessmen pitched them as inexpensive and durable alternatives to constantly replacing reams of paper towels. Jet dryers joined the fray starting in 1993 in Japan and then hit the US in the early 2000s. And ever since, debates have raged about which method is best. Most recently, in Cheddar's team meetings.
It's such a bother.
I'll just wipe my hands on my pants, which I know is disgusting, but it's an effective way to dry your hands when you don't want to wait for hand dryers.
So that's not the way you dry your hands. Have I shown you the script? It's not effective.
A 2012 study evaluated each option on four criteria. Paper towels and jet dryers remove 90% of water in 10 seconds. Hot air dryers need 40. And let's be honest, how many of us commit that much time to drying our hands? Environmentally, however, paper towels lose. Taking into account their whole life cycle, they release more greenhouse gases than the hot air dryers. And jet dryers are far better than both. But these last two criteria are where the science gets, well, messy. A clear winner hasn't yet been determined. Electric dryers have long been denounced as germ-spewing menaces to public health. A slew of studies accused them of blasting germs all over our freshly soaped hands, either by sucking them in from the surrounding air or, worse, creating an environment for them to grow. They have such a bad reputation that some people, like Cheddar's video director Carl, have sworn off them entirely. So, Dr. Morrow, any advice?
Well, look, okay, firstly, the warm air dryers, bacteria aren't growing on the surface. I mean, it gets hot and it gets cold and gets hot and cold all day, but it's not a consistent temperature. We don't have bacteria growing on the surface. And so the worry then is, can this force of air, even with the sheer force ones, can this force of air be blowing germs around the environment? And yes, it can.
So then paper towels?
Is it cleaner to dry the hands with a paper towel? Not necessarily. The germs can settle on paper towels, which means we pick up paper towels and we wipe our hands with already contaminated towels.
It turns out this whole hygiene and efficiency debate is basically a wash. Even the WHO and CDC don't take a stance.
The problem then isn't that an air hand dryer may spread them around a little bit more, or that we use paper towels or not. It's that they're in the air and they really shouldn't be. And that's where good toilet hygiene comes into play.
If you weren't already horrified by public bathrooms, allow me to introduce the toilet plume. A single flush can propel thousands of microorganisms skyward, where they either linger or fall to a nearby surface.
We're not always infected and spreading disease. It's only if someone has a gastrointestinal infection, for example, and goes to the bathroom, there's now going to be contaminants in that toilet. The problem is, when you get sick, you tend to use the bathroom more often, and it's one way that it spreads.
If the science of hand drying is muddled, the science of toilet plumes is crystal clear. This study detected droplets 5 feet above the toilet for more than 20 seconds after the flush. This one detected a nasty bug 10 inches above the bowl for up to 90 minutes after the flush. And Dr. Morrow himself found that, well, I'll let him tell you.
They did a study where they flushed a toilet many, 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 many times, you know, 6, 10, 20 times, and they found that even every flush, even though it looked clean, was still spreading contaminants around the area.
That means your flush of the office toilet is still launching remaining particles from the flushes of your coworkers into the communal restroom airspace. So what's a germaphobe to do in the face of such pestilential perils? Dr. Morrow has some tips. 1. If there's a lid, put it down before flushing.
Not an airtight seal, but it's okay. And at least prevents a bit of that spread of contaminants.
Unfortunately, most public restrooms don't have lids, which brings us back to, obviously, wash and dry your hands thoroughly, using whatever method you want, except shaking your hands or rubbing them on your shirt. Have you learned nothing, you absolute monster?
And I know we're talking a lot today about, which method to dry your hands, but as long as people are drying, everything's great.
3. If you have any influence over bathroom construction, prioritize good airflow.
Having a big open window and fresh airflow coming through that bathroom is one way just to clear out any contaminants when they come through.
And finally, 4. If you're sick and you can stay home, please do.
We can have the best seals on toilets and look after everything and wash our hands correctly, and someone coughs into the air and all that has led to nothing. If we don't go out when ill, that solves the problem from the get-go.
We hope you enjoyed this public service announcement from Cheddar's unofficial volunteer public health department. In the comments, defend your preferred drying method and attack those who disagree with you. And be sure to click subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss future important announcements like this one.